Reynolds back in a hurry. Reynolds to the hole. We're trying to get free shoot scores. To Keisha Granberry on target.
Lundy to the house. Touchdown, Virginia.
Cavalier Sports Weekly is presented by the Virginia Lottery, where all profits benefit Virginia's public schools grades K through 12. By clean, safe, reliable propane. Propane, exceptional energy. And brought to you in part by the Virginia Athletics Foundation, dedicated to providing scholarship, operational, and facility support for the Virginia Athletics Program. On this edition of Cavalier Sports Weekly, presented by the Virginia Lottery.
And you know, I was like, what do you mean drops? He's like, probably had like a 90% chance of dying.
We really are taking a liking for Zeta.
Touchdown!
You know, he's like, yeah, my heart's messed up. We're like, what? You know, what are you talking about?
Welcome to Cavalier Sports Weekly. I'm Christian Olsen, number 11 on the football team. We've got a great show for you today with highlights from the Florida State game, a feature on my teammate Jonathan Stupar, and a special basketball preview. But first, here's the play of the week.
The play of the week is brought to you by SunTrust Mortgage. We make the American dream come true every day.
Snelling is in, Lundy the tailback. Higgins, the play fake. Higgins looking in zone now, forced out of the pocket. Higgins throw, complete, Lundy at the 10, to the 5, to the house, touchdown! Touchdown, Cavs!
Well, my man didn't come, they came on a blitz, my man didn't come, and I got out behind the blitzer, and basically just saw me. That really gave us the momentum, and I think that kind of took a little bit of wind out of him.
And we'll be right back with more highlights on Cavalier Sports Weekly.
Welcome back to the show. Florida State came to town on Saturday for a primetime matchup. Let's take a look at the game story.
For on-demand Virginia football video highlights, visit VirginiaSportsTV.com.
It's a beautiful fall evening at the University of Virginia in the Carl Smith Center. Tonight, the Cavaliers host the number 4 Florida State Seminoles. 10 years ago in 95, when Virginia beat Florida State at that time, it was the highest-ranked team they had ever beaten. Tonight, they're hoping history repeats itself.
Weatherford got right out of the shotgun. They're coming after him. He got hit, throws. It's going to be long and intercepted. Forsyth, Hamilton, 20, 25, out of bounds. Hamilton makes the play at the 28-yard line.
Cavaliers have a 3rd and 16 at the FSU 49. Higgins, the play fake. The blitz is on. Higgins rushed out of the pocket. Now looks to throw. Long. It's going to be caught by Byers. 35, 30, 25 to the 21-yard line.
1st and 10, 22-yard line. Forsyth, Hesmark. Higgins rushes out of the pocket. Higgins looks to throw, end zone, and it is caught. Far side, touchdown, Virginia!
I mean, we just wanted to put it in the air, really, you know, test the secondary and see if they could really make plays, you know. And our receivers and tight ends, running backs did a good job catching the ball and making plays.
That'll be Chris Davis. Toss sweep going to Booker. Booker far side, got open 45, 50, 45, down the sideline, 30, 25, 20, 10, 5. Touchdown, Florida State on a toss sweep.
Cavs with two tight ends and a running back from the 37-yard line. Higgins, the play fake, the throw. Maximum protection over the middle. He hit the tight end. Blasted at the 40-yard line, down the far sideline. It was a heck of a catch. It will be a 50-yard attempt. Snap back, ball down, the kick is up. It is long enough. It is good. He hit it.
Yeah, you know, I've been waiting for that long one all year. We just haven't really been in the situation for me. And, you know, God came through today, man. We were just totally blessed in every aspect.
Receiver left side for Weatherford on his shotgun. 3rd and goal from the 7. Weatherford drops back, swings the screen to the right side of Booker, and the Cavs are going to cover it well. It's a yard gain of Marcus Hamilton, the corner. Comes up to make the play, and a terrific defensive stand by Virginia there.
Snap back, ball down, and kick is up. 22-yard field goal is good. We are tied at 10-10.
What I'm really proud of with D is that a lot of times we just held him out of the end zone. And That's a big part of the game.
Michael Johnson, the lone running back. Hagans looking to throw. Hagans now forced out of the pocket. Hagans will let the ball go. It is up and caught. Fontel Mines goes high and catches it at the Florida State 45.
Incredible playmaking out there, the plays that he created on his own after the play broke down. Just fantastic job. But probably is, there probably haven't been many games played by a Virginia quarterback too much better than that.
Just inside the near side hash mark for Hughes. Snap back, ball down. The kick is up. It is long enough, and it is good. Connor Hughes breaks the tie. Virginia has the lead.
I mean, when you're playing a team like that, it's just so much, you just get focused, you know. It's just so much easier to really get into what you're doing.
1 yard line. Booker is the tailback for Florida State from the one. Weatherford to throw out of the end zone and looking deep and trying to hit a deep home run ball. The Cavs go after it. It's intercepted on the far side. The Cavs make a great break on it. Chris Gore on the pick.
The secondary has stepped up big each week, and I feel as though that we're going to continue to get better every single week, and we just want to continue to play. We're confident as a group. We stick together. We just try to have fun out there.
Snap back, ball down, the kick is up. Connor Hughes has nailed it. It's good. 16-10, Virginia.
Wide again, two right and left. Fred Rouse is in. Weatherford to throw. He is going to be hit and sacked. The Cavaliers got him. Kai Palm, the linebacker, Brennan Schmidt. One running back and two tight. Deep drop by Hagans. Hagans wants to throw. Looking deep. Down. The catch, 20-yard line. He nailed him.
Marcus is it. You can count on him at any time to make a big play. Whenever we need him, whenever a play is needed, he's going to make a big play.
Hagans, the play fake. Hagans looking in zone now, forced out of the pocket. Hagans throw. Complete Lundy at the 10, to the 5, to the house. Touchdown. Touchdown, Cavs. No flags.
And we got a touchdown, and that really gave us the momentum. And I think that kind of took a little bit of win out of it.
Michael Johnson alone running back. They show the blitz and back out of it. Deep drop, Hagans. Hagans rolls the pocket. Hagans now may try to run and get out of it. Hagans throws and looks. He's got a man complete. 28-yard line coming back to the ball. Right in between the hash marks. Snap back. Ball down. The kick is up. And it is long enough. It is good. Connor Hughes has got another one. Cavs up 16. Weatherford to throw. Looks downfield. Throws. Has got a man. And the catch. 22-yard line.
FSU far from done. Weatherford underneath. And it's going to be Davis. Davis got away from one man, got the block. Spins,
oh,
makes a play, 10-5, touchdown, Florida State.
Wow, what a run he, what a move he put on at the end of that.
Or Davis left. Weatherford drops back, throws over the middle. Man, it's going to be incomplete. Knocked away, intended for Willie Reed, and Ryan Best got a hand on it. He played it perfectly. 32-yard field goal attempt, snap back, ball down. The kick is up, it is long enough, and it is good. So Florida State gets three.
Florida State had us on our heels with a couple of those drives, but at the end, the kids really bucked up at the end of the drive and took points away from them, and that certainly was a big factor.
Behind Hagans under center. It'll be Sandy in motion to the far side. Hagans drops back, looks for Dayon. The throw, and it's going to be incomplete. Penalty flags everywhere. Pass interference against Florida State. They were all over Dayon Williams. And that will give Virginia the first down with 3:11 to play. 26-yard line for Florida State. Weatherford drops back to throw. Weatherford looks deep, throws, and it's going to be intercepted by the Cavs. Tony Franklin wraps it up at the 45-yard line. Let's celebrate a win.
Final stats.
I think, you know, we really had the opportunity to do a lot of great things today. You know, we wanted to go out there and just score a lot of times and make sure we got our plays together. We really wanted to make sure our execution was down, and we were real happy that they just let it go, and it was a great result.
You know, we got a great win tonight. Go out, enjoy it, have fun. But come Monday morning, we got to go back to the drawing board and get better and get ready for North Carolina.
For complete Cavaliers sports coverage, watch VirginiaSportsTV.com.
I watch VirginiaSportsTV.com.
When Bart surfing the web, he goes to www.VirginiaSportsTV.com.
If you love Cavalier football, then check out VirginiaSportsTV.com so you can get a better look at me and some of my teammates.
For exclusive all-access video of Virginia football, visit VirginiaSports.com and look for the links to VirginiaSportsTV.com. Coming up next.
And, you know, I was like, what do you mean drops? He's like, probably had like a 90% chance of dying.
Everyone on our team feels lucky to have Jonathan Stupar playing with us, and not just because he's a really good tight end. During the offseason, John was diagnosed with a potentially fatal heart abnormality. Surgery was risky, but thankfully he pulled through and made an amazing recovery. Jonathan Stupar is your Student Athlete of the Week.
The Student Athlete of the Week is presented by the Virginia Lottery. In 2005, the Virginia Lottery contributed a record $423 million to public schools throughout the Commonwealth.
Going into last year at camp, you know, I was stronger, I was faster, you know, I was more hungry. Just going in there, you know, I just tried to do my best all the time. And, you know, it was really paying off in camp. You know, I was doing well. I was doing real well until the second to last day of camp when I broke my foot.
There's no words that can explain it, you know. I mean, he wanted it so bad to get in there and play, and then, you know, his foot just breaks.
That really just hurt because, you know, I had so much expectation for that year, and for it to kind of almost just go down the drain, it felt like was just kind of crushing. You know, as I was recovering from the second foot operation, you know, we went to Boise and stuff, and then we went home for Christmas break. I was watching TV, and my vision started just going. It started just going to where at a point where I could just see the TV and basically what was in the middle of the TV, and everything else was black. And it was kind of really scary at the time because it's not really normal. And, you know, I just kind of blinked my eyes real hard and shook my head, slapped myself around, you know, what's going on. And it didn't go away, so I went up to my mom and dad and I was like, you know, I kind of lost my vision. I can't really see except for what's in front of me. And being the good parents they are, they rushed me to the hospital and to the emergency room. And I had some blood work done and had a CAT scan, and they didn't find anything.
He came back to school. We saw him in the training room, and I asked if he had an EKG done, which had not been done, which is fine. I mean, you know, they thought it was more central nervous system related. Got an EKG, and the EKG showed the conduction abnormality known as Wolff-Parkinson-White syndrome.
Wolff-Parkinson-White syndrome is... It's a case where in your heart you have, pretty sure you have four circuits that there's a sequence that goes through them, and it stimulates your heart to beat. And I had two of them. So like say the sequence was A, B, C, D, I would have like two Bs. And what it would do is when it would send the pulse, it could go to A to either B and down, or what it could do is short circuit. If it goes through both of them, my heart will beat twice as fast, which is really bad, or it could short circuit and my heart could just stop.
I mean, it was just, we came back from winter break and, you know, he was like, yeah, my heart's messed up. And we're like, what? You know, what are you talking about?
I wasn't allowed to do a jumping jack, a push-up, you know, they were like, don't do anything. You walk everywhere you go, you drive to every class, you know, nothing. Then I went and saw Dr. Mounsey at the University of Virginia Hospital. You know, I really didn't know how severe it was until he sat down with me and, you know, he told me, you know, it's a blessing, you know, it's a miracle that you broke your foot. Because, I mean, if you were out there working out, trying to get back into shape, you know, you could have dropped. And, you know, I was like, what do you mean dropped? And he's like, probably had like a 90% chance of dying. And, you know, that's when it hit me. I was like, wow, I won't do a jumping jack, I promise.
Yeah, the procedure, risky procedure. I mean, essentially you're putting a catheter through your thigh blood vessel. You push this catheter into the heart and you map the electrical circuitry of the heart, all right, essentially. And then you find that bad pathway and then you zap it.
Before the surgery, I remember Dr. Mounsey telling my dad, you know, there's a chance that he might not come out of this. And, you know, it's when you say that to a father, you know, my dad told me, he was like, you know, when I told him about it, he was like, are you sure you want to have this surgery? I was like, Dad, they won't let me play football again unless I have the surgery. He was like, John, do you want to have the surgery?
Risky procedure, but very successful. And thanks to Dr. Manzi, we were able to get him back on the field. And as you can see, he's playing well this year and great kid, you know, and we're fortunate.
Normally they burn it off, but it was so close that they ended up freezing it off. So they had to hold it on there on the bad circuit for, I think it was 5 minutes. Without moving on a microscopic thing, which takes some nerves. And, you know, he did it, got it on the first try, took about 2.5 hours, woke up, and and I was fine.
We're lucky that we have the opportunity to do it, Virginia, you know. We've got the EKG machine in the training room, and we're just blessed with so many good medical facilities around here that we're able to do it. And so many places don't have those blessings and the luck that we have, that we have all this here at Virginia, that we're able to get it diagnosed, send them to the right people, get them back on the field in a month.
He's just getting off of foot surgery, too. So it was just, you know, we were helping him before with the foot. He was always on crutches. Now, you know, he's just had surgery on his heart. So we were kind of getting routine with this. So it's not something you really want to get used to.
He's gone through so much in such a short amount of time. And now to see him out there excelling, you know, catching big passes, making big blocks, it's really a good experience.
He has a great outlook on life. You know, after his surgery, he came home and he said, it's all better, you know, and smiling. That's the beauty of John. You know, he's always going to bring a smile to your face, no matter what, rain, snow, or sleet.
I go out there every day now knowing that there was a chance that I wouldn't be playing football, that I wouldn't be here, you know, and it took something like that for me to realize how you know, precious life is and how great of an opportunity I have here to play college football.
He's always happy living in the moment, and it's always fun to be around a guy like that.
Sometimes we joke with him and say, you know, you could be a cartoon character. You know, you just, people see you and, you know, they start laughing, and, you know, you just bring a smile to everyone's face.
You never know when your time's up, you know. You never know when your clock's going to stop ticking, and it's just amazing, you know, to go out there every day and compete in the college level and play football. And I cherish every moment of it.
There's excitement in the air right now at U-Haul as our men's and women's basketball teams begin practicing for their final season at this historic arena. We got a closer look at the two teams, and they're the focus of this week's Who's Heating Up.
Who's Heating Up is brought to you by Propane, exceptional energy.
We really are taking a liking to Coach Lado. I mean, we're really excited about him coming in with a lot of energy and things like that. And his message to us is real positive. And everybody on the team, I mean, is just looking up to him, and we're just ready to follow, I mean, the path he has for us.
Yeah, I think he's a tremendous coach. I think he knows what it takes in order for us to win. You know that we have to work hard, and you know he's pushing us to the limit, places we've never been before. You know, we just gotta step up, accept the challenge, and just get ready for this season.
You know, we've gotten up early, just about every single morning, and the days have been long, and they've been asked to do a whole lot. I think they realize that to be better than they were defensively is something that we'll have to do, and that's a starting point.
Well, we really are buying into it because we know without defense, we can't win. So, I mean, the first practice was real tough. I mean, it was all defense. It was blown away by, like, the commitment we're going to have to make, I mean, to be a good team.
We have a team that is going to be a lot of fun to coach. 40% of the team will be first-year players. Losing five players from last year's team, a good deal of scoring, a good deal of rebounding, good deal of leadership is going to be tough to replace in this year, but we feel like we have a talented group of kids coming back and a very energetic and vivacious group of first years who are ready to help us probably in a supporting role.
Find out why more people are choosing clean, safe, reliable propane. Visit usepropane.com. Propane, exceptional energy.
Hey, this is Bart. Stay tuned for more Cavalier Sports Weekly.
Welcome back to the show. The Commonwealth Challenge continued this week as our 6th-ranked women's soccer team traveled to Blacksburg to take on Virginia Tech. This in-state rivalry is featured in our Olympic Sports Spotlight.
The Olympic Sports Spotlight is presented by the Virginia Athletics Foundation.
Let's take it to
them. Team on three. One, two, three.
Team! We take a lot of pride in teams that we're playing from Virginia. That's something that we talk about every year since they're in the conference and it's a rival game for the challenge. I think it made that much more of a difference.
Coming down here to Virginia Tech, we knew it would be a big game. It's a big rivalry. We knew that they were going to come out real strong, and we just had to make sure we came and matched its intensity.
We felt if we could get a couple goals or just wanted to get it started, I think we could put them on their heels.
We really wanted to come out and try to get a goal within the first 15 minutes, and we did that. I put the ball out wide to Sarah Curtis, and she had an unbelievable ball in, and I headed it.
That first goal was beautiful, and you know, it makes a big difference. When you can get goals, it gives your team confidence, and it takes away from the other teams. We were pleased with that early start for us. I think that was a big difference in the game. I think it allowed us to relax, and it took the pressure off our backs a little bit.
Way to go, Quinny. All right, good work. Good work. Good work.
Thanks for watching Cavalier Sports Weekly. We travel to North Carolina on Saturday to renew the South's oldest rivalry. Until next time, go Hoos!
Cavalier Sports Weekly is presented by the Virginia Lottery, where all profits benefit Virginia's public schools grades K through 12. By clean, safe, reliable propane. Propane, exceptional energy. And brought to you in part by the Virginia Athletics Foundation, dedicated to providing scholarship, operational, and facility support for the Virginia Athletics program.